Toastmasters grew out of an effort to meet the needs of a group of men in Bloomington, Illinois, more than half a century ago. In those days, I was a YMCA secretary. Many of the men with whom I was associated in that work needed help in talking and in meeting other people. They had ideas, but they did not know how to express them. However, they did not want a formal class in public speaking, and when I suggested a club in which they could learn to talk by talking, they welcomed the idea.
We inspire each other to move beyond whatever is holding us back. What's holding you back? Be it personal or professional, large or small, we must first believe that we can. And Toastmasters can instill that belief in us if we let it.
Many Toastmasters become excellent public speakers. This is not the purpose of the program. The purpose of Toastmasters is to help all its members help themselves by learning to speak effectively and with confidence at any time and under any circumstance.
We provide service to our clubs and our members within this outstanding organization. But most importantly, we provide service to the world. We take the skills and talents we learn in Toastmasters and make our professions better, our communities better, our families better, and ultimately, we change and improve the world.
In tough economic times, we've grown about 5% this last year. We're in 106 countries, and we have about 250,000 members. Toastmasters is an opportunity for people to come together and to practice communication and leadership skills. It's not a classroom-style environment. It's more of a workshop where you actually get the opportunity to put into practice what you're learning.
Yes, many thousands of men throughout the free world have profited by Toastmasters training and have been led into more productive living, more satisfactory living by this means. I hope to see many thousands more given the advantage of this training in the years to come.
Name an effective political leader in history who couldn't speak well.
Mr. Gorbachev, tear down this wall.
There aren't any.
Because when it comes to a disease,
freedom
like
requires leadership, and leadership requires oratory. You have to speak to be heard.
I have a dream.
It's all about personal growth and guts.
Never give in. Never, never, never.